We have the biggest one-day death toll so far from this in the U.S., 575 dead. For Americans watching now and who rely on you, you're a voice of calm and a voice of facts in the midst of all this. What should Americans prepare themselves for in these coming couple of weeks?
Well, it's a critical time, Jim, in the next couple of weeks, because as you know, we have very intensive mitigation, the kinds of things that you've described on the show with the physical separation. If you look now, we're starting to see glimmers that that is actually having some dampening effect. But that does not take away from the seriousness of what you just described on the show. We clearly are seeing cases going up. The people in New York are in a difficult situation, and what they're trying to do appropriately is make the best of it by opening up facilities that might decompress the surge of cases that they're having. And you described it very well, and that's the reason why things like the Javits Center, getting the comfort into the harbor to be able to do that. We are still in a very difficult situation. We hope, and I believe it will happen, that we may start seeing a turnaround, but we haven't seen it yet. We're just pushing on the mitigation to hope that we do see that turnaround.
So tell us where you're seeing what you described just there as early signs. I know that New York has seen a decline in the rate of growth in new infections. What else are you seeing that gives you some hope that the curve is being flattened somewhat?
So what happens, Jim, is that it occurs in phases. If you look from day to day of the number of new cases that require hospitalization, when you're really going up exponentially, it increases from day to day. Once you start to level off, then you're going to have less people who are going to be going into intensive care. And then later on, because it always lags, you'll see a decrease in deaths. So what we're starting to see right now is just the inklings, and I don't want to put too much stock on it because you don't want to get overconfident. You just want to keep pushing on what you're doing. You're starting to see that the daily increases are not in that steep incline. They're starting to be able to possibly flatten out. I mean, again, you look at it carefully, hope it's going in the right direction, but that's what we really are trying to attain, that multi-phase component where it ultimately starts to come down.
Well, that is welcome news, and thanks so much for sharing that. I want to ask for what else helps. So if social distancing is helping, and we're beginning to see some effect of that, what about masks? Now, the president raised the prospect of seeing recommending all Americans wear some form of mask here. Should all Americans be doing that? And to be more specific, is that about something like a bandana, et cetera? Because we already know of the shortages of medical masks, PPE masks, right, even for healthcare workers.
Well, Jim, the idea of getting a much more broad community-wide use of masks outside of the healthcare setting is under very active discussion at the task force. The CDC group is looking at that very carefully. The thing that has inhibited that a bit is to make sure that we don't take away the supply of masks from the healthcare workers who need them. But when we get in a situation where we have enough masks, I believe there will be some very serious consideration about more broadening this recommendation of using masks. We're not there yet, but I think we're close to coming to some determination. Because if, in fact, a person who may or may not be infected wants to prevent infecting someone else, one of the best ways to do that is with a mask. So perhaps that's the way to go. And again, I say, Jim, that's under very active consideration. We'll be discussing it today, this afternoon, at the task force meeting.
I see. And to be clear, you're saying when the supply is sufficient to allow that.
Right. Because the one thing, Jim, you don't want to do, you don't want to take masks away from the healthcare providers who are in a real and present danger of getting infected. That would be the worst thing we do. If we have them covered, then you could look back and say, maybe we need to broaden this.
Yep. Speaking of broadening, if I can, from the beginning, and I know that